My name is Paul Smith, and this is my story. To me, that's my purpose. They look at you on the surface and think you have everything together. You know, you're looking good, you're smelling good. But not knowing that you too have been through some very painful situations. And that's really when I saw the face of God. You know, right out of college, I had a meteoric rise into corporate America. I started my career with Bristol Myers Squibb in 1995. I really reached the pinnacle of my earning potential, if you will, as a professional sales representative, and was able to buy some nice things. I drove nice cars, traveled extensively. I had my own home at the age of 27. So at a very young age, I experienced what most people live, you know, search their whole lifetime and work their whole lifetime for. I was making between $75,000 a year to $100,000, and then increased from there. In 2003 is when I experienced my first layoff. And at the time, it didn't seem like a layoff. I took it more as a vacation. I took some time, ended up partying, going to Brazil, traveling to Europe, New York City, you have it, et cetera, et cetera. And then as a result, you know, you're looking at your bank account and your money's dwindling. And I said, well, I think it's time for me to go get a job. Guess what? It didn't happen that easily. I think that began to break me down in terms of my arrogance. Man, I was facing foreclosure, repossession of my vehicles. Virtually had to almost clear out my 401k just to get back on my feet. You're looking at a person that I made twice as much money as both my parents together. And here I am leaning on my parents. I was in my house one day and just really having a rough time with dealing with all the emotions, all the feelings that I was going through. My mother called me up and she could sense it in my voice. She came over and she sat down in the kitchen and she just opened up the Bible and says, I want to share some verses with you. And I didn't really feel that. You know, you're in pain. I mean, you know, you're hurt. You know, and depression gets to set in. And my mother walked into the room and just pulled me to the side and said, hey, get on your knees. She pulled me on my knees and she just prayed for me. She prayed there with me and said, you know, right now in the name of Jesus, I bind every demonic spirit that's taking over my son. And even now I get emotional. I'm thinking about it because most people say, hey, that's what a mother's supposed to do. She's supposed to take care of her kids. But that right there was very real for me because at that moment, I felt God. I felt the presence of the Lord. And it was just like a tingling just all over my body. And I knew right then and there that it was time for me to turn. It's time for me to turn the corner. Because at that moment, I believe God spoke to me and said that if I didn't get on the righteous path, that I was going to disintegrate. I was going to turn to dust. And so when you look at that road to Damascus, it was one where I learned a lot about who I am. And that's really when I saw the face of God. And a lot of times they say, well, people only see God when they go through adversity. And they don't know God when times are good. Well, I think that was I was a living example of what that is. And trust me, people that I thought were my friends and even family members turned their back on me. And it was a very painful experience. You know, God has blessed me with an unparalleled drive and will to not quit. Well, at this point, I understand that God has put a purpose in me. And it took me to go through that revelation or that revolution, if you will, that transformation to go through that, to understand that God's grace, His purpose is for me to share that conviction with other people. And they said, well, if He can do it, then I can do it. And I know that sounds kind of corny, but it's true. Sometimes you have to see a living flesh example of a person that falls and stumbles and gets back up. You fall again, you get back up. That's why God's grace, His mercy, salvation, that's why He died on the cross for us. At this point in my life, I can look back on it and say, you know, whew, you know. And I know that He gave me a lot of blessings, a lot of energy, a lot of passion, a lot of things in me cultivated in the right way that I could be a blessing to someone else. And so I guess that's why I'm here giving you my testimony.